Welcome to another video of Lazarus with TMS Web Core. Today I'm going to show you how to create a REST client for any REST web service. As it happens, the web service is powered by an XData server. So this demo or video is also a proof of concept that you can consume an XData web service with any REST client. It's no different than any other web service, just as for the VCL and for FireMonkey, you have dedicated controls that allow you to consume these services easier. Also, for TMS Web Core in Red Studio, you also have a web client that is dedicated for use with XData service methods and database methods. However, you can do all that with Lazarus as well. This video is part of the school data series and thus will use the school data as a data source. Furthermore, the XData server that we are going to use has been explained in detail in the video series. So now you see in the background that the server is started and the endpoint is HTTP localhost port 80/flex. So invoking that URL, you see we have our schools data set available. If we go to the schools path, we have the schools data set with all the schools in the area. That's the data set. Go to that video if you need further explanation about what data you find in the data set. What is important for us is the JSON has an item called value, and that is where all the tuples or all the rows of the data set are. So keep value in mind. So let's create the application using project, new project, TMS Web Core application. Okay. And the form is going to consist of a grid as the visual representation of the data. Let's see where we find the grid. It's on the TMS Web Data Controls. There is the TVAPDB grid. And of course, it has to be aligned AL client. It will fill the whole browser window. In order to retrieve the data from the web service, we need the components from the TMS Web Data Access Palette page. First of all, there's the web client dataset, and then there's the web client connection. The connection establishes the connection to the web service and then allows the web client to use the connection to retrieve the dataset. And of course, we need the data source to connect the dataset to the data grid. And this is actually the first thing that I'm going to do, because that's basically the most common thing that you forget to do and wonder, why isn't there any data in my grid? So you connect the data source of the grid to the web data source and the web data source to the web client data set. The web client data set, of course, is to be connected to the web client connection, and the web client connection is the only one that accesses or knows about the web service and thus gets the URL HTTP localhost port 80 Flix schools. That's it. We're not going to set active to true at design time. That's something we're going to do at runtime. So what do we need to do at runtime? Of course, we need to trigger the connection. That's what we're going to do in the form. So we're going to select the form, the event, onCreate. And in onCreate, we set the web client connection active to true. And as these are all asynchronous events, we don't know when they finish. We have to also implement the web client connection event, which is called after connect. So after the connection has been established, we then fill the data set with the records from the web service, because we know that the connection has been established successfully. And this uses the web client data set one, and the method is called load. And the options are empty, and we also don't want an after load event method. So this is nil. So now our data set hopefully has records, and as soon as the data set has been loaded, just for to give you a complete picture of the events, how they are being thrown, the web client dataset has an event called after open. So this after open event is triggered when load is complete. We don't need this because the graphical user interface or the data source actually monitors the data set and notices, oh, it has been opened, so now I can show the data in the grid. And that is all you need to know to display data from a web service with TMS Web Core. One final thing about the connection though. If you look at the properties, we specified the URL for the web service. If you remember the JSON that has been returned, we also need to specify value as the data node, because the data of the data set is under the property named value. So that's it. Let's run this application. Here you see the running application. The grid fills the whole browser window. All the information is being displayed. And of course, you would be able to modify the column types, the column description. You would be able to make the modifications to the graphical user interface that you're used to. However, that's not the focus of this video. We're already at the end of this video. I hope you're just as amazed as I am how easy it is to access REST web services with Lazarus and TMS Web Core.